We've now arrived at the elusive Holly Terrace, which, next to the Memorial Terrace, most closely resembles a Gothic cathedral, with its magnificent soaring arches, dim lighting, hanging lamps, and stained glass windows. Its majesty reserved, for the most part, for the dead. As we make our way through the quiet halls of the Holly Terrace, we would be remiss if we didn't stop and pay our respects to one of the 20th century's greatest and most beloved musical performers. Resting here at the end of the Sanctuary of Ascension, the King of Pop, Michael Jackson, his sarcophagus painted in colorful light from the Ascension windows. He's a man who needs no introduction and will not soon be forgotten. Michael rose to prominence on the music scene with his brothers in the highly successful pop soul group, the Jackson 5, in the 60s and 70s. With his popularity on the rise, he branched out on his own to pursue a solo career. By the 80s, Michael was a dominant force in music, becoming one of the best-selling, most awarded artists in history. His hits include Beat It, Billie Jean, Bad, Man in the Mirror, Black or White, and my favorite of his songs, Thriller, which just happened to play on the radio the day I visited Michael. I figured that was his way of saying hello. His 1982 album, Thriller, is the best-selling album of all time. And the music video for Thriller was revolutionary, produced as a short horror film, directed by John Landis, and narrated by the legendary Vincent Price. As he was preparing for his comeback tour in 2009, this is it. Michael found it difficult to sleep. His physician began administering dangerous levels of propofol, which eventually led to cardiac arrest and Michael's untimely death. He was just 50. Michael was inducted twice into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, as well as the Songwriters Hall of Fame. A rare talent, gone too soon. Before we move on, let's make sure Michael has some flowers. On behalf of millions the world over, Michael, thank you for the music. You are missed.